The Infinity Data Source is an open source plugin that lets you query and visualize data from various external sources such as REST APIs, CSV, JSON, and/or GraphQL directly into your Grafana dashboards. In this video, I'll be guiding you on how to get started with the Infinity Data Source plugin. By the end of this, you'll know how to install the Infinity Data Source and add it to your Grafana environment. You'll also learn how to configure basic authentication and have the knowledge to select a private data connection, especially when working with internal datasets. Finally, you'll build a dashboard using CSV and/or JSON data. Before jumping into this video tutorial, there are a few prerequisites that you need to know. First, you need to have a Grafana Cloud account in which you are an administrator. You also need to have a CSV or a JSON file that's populated with data and accessible via a URL. In this demo, I'll be using a public dataset, but if you're working with internal data, make sure you have the knowledge of the authentication used to secure the endpoint. With internal datasets, it's also highly recommended that you set up a private data source connection and that the PDC agent is up and running so that the connection is secure. If you haven't done this part yet, make sure you check out our learning journey for creating a private data source connection. Feel free to pause the video here, but when you're ready, let's get right into it. The first step is to install the Infinity Data Source plugin because it's not installed by default. In your Grafana environment, open the navigation menu on the left. Click Connections. Enter Infinity in the search bar and press Enter. You should see the Infinity tile. Then, in the upper right corner, click Install. You should see the message Install Requested. This might take a few minutes. After the data source is installed, we need to add it to our Grafana environment. To add, navigate back to Connections, but this time click Data Sources. Click Add New Data Source and search for Infinity. Go ahead and click the tile and add a name. You can give this a more meaningful name, but I'll just stick with the default. If you're using internal data and require authentication, you need to provide an authentication method and add the respective credentials. To do that, click Setup Authentication, or you can also click Authentication on the left navigation menu. Select the authentication method for your dataset. If it's basic authentication, you can add the username and password here. Since I am working on a public dataset, I don't have to provide any authentication details. Next, let's test the connection to the data endpoint. To do that, click Health Check on the left navigation menu and enable the custom Health Check toggle. For this demo, I'm going to use two endpoints, one that returns CSV data and another that returns JSON data. In your case, you should use a URL that returns the data that you want. When you're ready, click Save and Test. You should see the following health check success message. To establish a secure connection between Grafana Cloud and your data endpoint, you need to select an active PDC agent and test the connection to Grafana Cloud. This is optional but highly recommended. Without the PDC, your queries and data are transmitted over the public internet, exposing them to potential security risks. I have a PDC agent running already, so in the Private Data Source Connect field, I can select the name of my PDC agent. To test the secure connection, click Save and Test, and you should see the following health check success message. We've done the installation and configuration. Now, the final piece of the puzzle is to build our dashboard. To build a dashboard with the Infinity Data Source, you can click Dashboards in the Grafana main menu. Afterwards, click New and select New Dashboard. You should see the following screen. On the empty dashboard, just click Add Visualization. Search for your Infinity data source and select it. Now, in the URL field, enter the endpoint of the data that you want to visualize. I'm going to start first with the CSV endpoint. Now, in the advanced options section, you should see a delimiter field. Most commonly for CSV data structure, this is a comma, but again, make sure to check your own CSV data structure in case you're using a different delimiter. Okay, now we're gonna visualize this as a time series data, so go ahead and click Add Column. Again, depending on the structure of your CSV, time series should have at least one timestamp entry. I have a column named Created Add, which corresponds to when the entry has been created. But since this is a CSV, everything is set as a string. So I need to format this as a time. And also set a title. So for example, Created Add. I'm going to continue adding columns for my field 1 and field 2 column. So for field 1, I'm going to give it a title of Density of Westbound Cars. And then I'm going to format this as a number instead. I'm going to do the same for field 2, but instead of westbound cars, we're going to give it a title of density of eastbound cars, and then also set the format as a number. Now, if you hit refresh, you should now see the preview of your dashboard. At this point, feel free to manipulate the time range. Once you're happy, click Save Dashboard, enter a title, and click Save. Now, you've just created your first dashboard using the Infinity data source. Now, let's visualize a JSON data. So, going back to my dashboard, let's click Add Visualization and select the Infinity data source. Next, I'm going to provide the URL for my JSON data, and then I'm going to expand the Parsing option and Result field section. In the rows/root field, I'm going to enter a row name. So let's go back and look at my JSON structure. In this particular example, I only want to look at feeds. Now, the Infinity data source can give you the ability to specify the section of data that's relevant for your visualization. This is useful because many APIs will return more data than what you want to show in Grafana, such as different metadata. Next, we're going to add columns the same way as we've done for the CSV example. We're going to add a column for the created at, set the title, and format it as time. And then we're gonna do the same for field 1 and field 2, setting both titles as density for westbound and eastbound cars, and then the format as both numbers. Now, if I hit refresh and just zoom to the correct data range, I should now see a dashboard preview. At this point, you can add a title for this panel. So in this example, I'm gonna name it as JSON example. Click Save, and now you should have two panels, one for visualizing JSON data and one for visualizing CSV data. And there you have it. In this video, you've learned how to install the Infinity Data Source plugin and add it to your Grafana environment. You also learn how to set up basic authentication and add a private data source connection. Finally, you learn how to build a dashboard using CSV and JSON data. I hope you found this video useful, and I'll see you on the next one. Happy visualizing!